ये
ठीक है,
वैसे आगे वैसे पीछे, वैसे आगे वैसे पीछे।
तो ये कंप्यूटर की तरफ क्या उधर है? गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक डॉक्टर दीवा कामिल, कोर्स डायरेक्टर ऑफ दिस ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम एंड हर एसोसिएट्स फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी टू डिलीवर यू ए लेक्चर। In fact, this would be my actually preliminary lecture on the taxonomical studies of macrofungi. In fact, whatever you do, molecular works, first you have to identify initially how and what fungus you are taking for your further studies. So for mushroom, you all know that there are about 15,000 species so far have been identified. And out of those, 7,000 species are edible and non-poisonous. In fact, Discoides in the first century AD first divided that these mushrooms are either edible or some poisonous also. Although poisonous mushrooms are not so much in quantity, they are not more than 5 to 7% of the total macrofungi noted so far. Actually, 2,000 species are nutraceutically important. 200 species of the, so out of 15,000 species are the mycorrhizal, in which 90% are endomycorrhizal fungus and 10% are ectomycorrhizal fungus. And fruiting bodies of this macrofungi, you all know what is macrofungi? You know what are macrofungi? Actually, macrofungi are those fungi in which you don't require the extra help. I mean, the microscopic studies with your naked eyes only you can see. These are visible from your naked eyes. So all those fungi are called the macrofungi. In fact, you know that fungi is not a plant-like structure. It is leaves, stem, all those things are there. And these all macrofungi are those fungi which are having their carpophores, which are very much visible from your naked eyes. And these carpophores are produced on the mycelium, mycelial-like structures. Okay? In fact, in 1986, the Agaricales in Mushroom Taxonomy, this is a classical book written by Singer in 1986, in which he has described about the macrofungi and given so much of details about the agaricales. And these all his studies were based on the morphotaxonomical studies, and most and micro structures were also taken into account for this, the spores and all those things about size and about the accumulations, the color of the spores, along with the morphotaxonomy of this fungus. Later on in Kirk et al. In 2008, based on molecular characterization, people described the taxonomy of this macrofungi. These macrofungi are diverse in use. I mean, they may be used as the food also. They may be used as nutraceuticals also. They may be used as the source of the medicines also. Lot of mushroom fungus these are being used now for preparing lot of medicines like Cordyceps sinensis. You all know this is a caterpillar fungus, better known as the caterpillar fungus, and other one is the Lentinula erodes, the Ganoderma lucidium. All these fungi are now being used throughout the world for production of the medicines. And in fact, the Walting in 1973 gave identification of the fungi, those having spores externally bound. I mean, there are two types, either these are externally bound or the spores are produced inside of the cells. So those having spores bound externally on clavate to cylindrical cell were classified into Basidiomycotina. You must all be knowing about the Basidiomycotina and Ascomycotina. So those having spores produced externally, they were classified into Basidiomycotina, and those which were producing spores in calvate, cylindrical and subglobose cells within inside the cells, these were classified into and grouped into Ascomycota. Okay? Got it? The Basidiomycota, there are two main classes, Hymenomycetes and Gasteromycetes, which are having macrofungi. In fact, all these details I cannot cover in one single lecture of 1 hour. So that's why I am taking the all the important things which are coming through. Okay? So Hymenomycetes comprise of the two main orders, Agaricales and Aphyllophorales, in which this is the case where the spores are forcibly discharged. All right? The spores are forcibly discharged, and when Basidia is present, the spore mature and spore print can be taken because the spores are forcibly discharged. In the case of the Hymenomycetes, again there are two groups, Phragmobasidiomycetes, this is jelly-like fungi, and mature Basidia are septate one. And in Holobasidiomycetes, Basidia have only one basal septum. All right. In Gasteromycetes, like puffball, earth balls, and stinghorn, etc., spores are not forcibly discharged here in this case, and spore print cannot be taken. And hymenium is closed at maturity. Hymenium is the structure, a thin membrane which is present over the spore producing part of the sporophore. That is the carpophore. In general, it is called as the carpophore. Or in the case of Basidiomycota, this fruiting structure which is produced by the mycelial cells, this is called as the basidiophore. All right. In fact, McNabb and Talbot 1973 divided Holobasidiomycetes into 6 order. And this was Exobasidiales, Brachybasidiales, Tholesnelials, Agaricales, Aphyllophorales, Dacromycetales are important. These are the internal leaf parasites of higher plants or non-internal parasites of higher plants. In case of internal leaf parasites, these Basidia emerge to form an external hymenium. Okay? And Exobasidiales, Basidia emerge in fruits like in Brachybasidiales order. Those which are not internal parasite of higher plants includes order Tholesnelials, Agaricales, Aphyllophorales and Dacromycetales. So you must be knowing that these macrofungi, either you can obtain it from the wood forests, these are going either on the higher plants. In case of microbial fungi, they are growing in association with the higher plant trees, maybe conifers or broadleaf strips, or they may be parasitic to the living plants, or they may be growing on the dead stumps of the stems of the dead plants, or in association, or sometimes they may grow also saprophytically on the dead organic matter, like dead plants, wood of the dead plants, on the straw, on the dung of the herbivorous or carnivorous animals. So depending upon the different cases of the macrofungi, they grow in different environment. All right. Ainsworth in Smith's dictionary in 2001, they have given 8 orders. These in phylum Basidiomycota, Basidiomycete, Agariconomycetidae, they have given classified into 8 orders. In new phylogenetic classification of the fungi by Hibbert et al., they have given Agaricomycotina and classified in different ways. Okay, so actually, in fact, the taxonomy of the macro fungi or the fungi from historical point of view, if you start taking it, previously it was taken about the how the morphologically they looks like under microscopic studies, and in case of macro fungi, how they look like. The naked eyes, what are about the color, what is the type of the spore producing organism they are producing, what the acidulation, color of the spores. So for so many things were taken into consideration. But later on, with the introduction of the molecular techniques, now they have been classified according to the molecular techniques, and further we will be coming on details about it. The molecular phylogenetic research which were taken into account after 2006, they have demonstrated that the Uagary clade is roughly equivalent to the singers which he described in 1986, Agaricales sensu stricto. The largest study of the Brandon Matheny et al., they published, there were 52 scientists involved in this paper, and they have classified Agaricales representing 6 genes, regions from 238 species in 146 genera to explore the phylogenetic grouping within the Agaricales. Earlier one, the again in the Singer 1986, they have considered that there are about 300 genus in Agaricales and about 12,000 species. So this analysis showed that most of the species tested could be grouped into 6 clades. These are Agaricoid, Tricholometoid, Marasmioid, Plutoid, Hygrophoretoid, and Plica Turopsidoid clades. They are different workers. And what about that? They take the different characteristics for identification and classifying these microfungi. So accordingly, they have placed different group, genuses, species in different families and all those things. So based on their type of thinking, different workers have classified Agaricales orders into number of families. So earlier, different workers, the most number of families, 26 families, they have classified Agaricales into 26 families. This Agaricales orders were divided into 26 families, okay. This order comprised of 3 suborders, 17 families, 230 genera, and approximately 500 species. Accordingly, what happens that from India, only 283 edible species have been reported by Purukasta and Chandra. But later on, Walting and Abraham in 1992, they considered about 650 species of the macro fungi or the mushroom fungi. These have been identified. So these macro fungi are known as the mushrooms. Now I tell you one thing, that the species, these are discoides, actually first identified in 100 AD, that these are either poisonous or non-poisonous. And some mushrooms are lethally poisonous. In fact, Claudius Caesar in 54 AD was killed by his wife by mushroom poisoning. And this by the known fungus at that time, it was the Amanita phalloides. Actually, the one species of the same genus may be edible and another species of the same genus may be poisonous. And better known example is the Amanita verpa and Amanita phalloides. These are actually very lethally poisonous, as they produce a lot of toxins, hematoxins, etc., which are poisonous when introduced either through intravenously through injections or consumed by within as a food material. All right. So before going to the taxonomy of the mushrooms, we should know about the part of the mushrooms also. The agaricus mainly, because this is the most of the cultivated species comes in the agaricus, and the cultivated species is the agaricus, pleurotus, lantanus, and all those species which are coming in this thing. So basically these are having two structures main. This is the cap, this is the pileus, and the stalk or stipe. In fact, in initial phases, the development takes place. These may be in different cases. Either the universal wheel is present, which the whole basidiocarp structure is covered under one hymenium, and as soon as this mushroom matures and start growing, becoming bigger in size, this universal wheel ruptures, and sometimes the partial wheel is also present, which is covering this inner portions of the this is hymenial structure in which all the gills are present. These gills actually are covered with the partial wheel, which is called as the hymenium, covering hymenium. This partial wheel covers here. This is the partial wheel, this is structure, and this structure is universal wheel. And as soon as this mushroom start growing in bigger in size, this partial wheel is there, and universal wheel ruptures. So when it ruptures from the base, it becomes, the parts remains here, which is called as the volva, and this is the stipe. And here, when here which is attached, it becomes a ring or annulus. Okay, it is called as the ring or annulus. And sometimes remnant of this universal wheels are attached here. Some portions are there, which so these blister like structures are formed over the cap of the mushrooms or the pileus of the mushroom or the main fruiting body of the mushroom, which is consumed as the food material. Actually, initially in 1980, 2021 and 2032, Fry considered that only the morphological features which were taken into accounts, the spore structure, microscopic characters of the spores, fruit bodies and color of these proteins, spore paint, microscopic studies of basidiocarp structure, later on initiated by Fred and Petulord. These demonstrated all these things that accordingly, if we consider all those structures into account along with the morphological features, if we go through the microscopic studies, then there are different groups. So they people said that this is not the case, and accordingly the classification will be changed. So later on, adopting these all these two characters, Rolf Singers in his book in 1986, he considered all those characters morphological, anatomical, and as well microscopic characters, along with the color of the spore, size of the spores, accumulation of the spores, all those things into account, and classified this in 18 families, which includes 23 genera. And these groups are still accepted by modern treatment based on DNA analysis of the eugenics. Ainsworth in 1973, he divided it in agaricus into 15 families. The characteristic features of the agaricus are fruit body development and hemangiocarpus, hymenium covering lamellae on the lower surface of the pileus. Okay, as I told you in the earlier slide, I showed you that the partial wheel covers the hymenium. Later on, it has been classified by Smith in 1973 and Singer into 16 to 18 families. Singer considered schizophyllaceae and polyporaceae family in agaricales, while Webster in 1980, he has placed these two families in the order Ephyloporales. So there is not a universal acceptance of any classification which were based on the morphological characters and microscopic characters of the spores, color, size, and all those things. Different workers have taken into account in details, and accordingly, based on their understanding, they have classified in different families and different orders. That's why, to avoid all those controversy, now the molecular technique has come, which will give you not the exact characteristic details. That you have to visualize through microscopic and macroscopic studies, but their identification part will be your 100% solid with the molecular techniques. That's why molecular techniques have taken into account now. Exopolis and MIMS, they people have included these polyporacy and bone and DGLs in affilophoreal sorters, while Singer, he has taken it into the agaricale sorter. So now agaricales have only 300 genera and about 5,000 species. This is all historical account about this thing. But before going through the macroscopic studies, you have to know about some basic understanding about the what are the different terminologies used. So there is a simple key for the families: Bonitaceae, Pegxiliaceae, Russulaceae, Hygrophoraceae, and Agaricaceae. In this case, Basidiocarp is soft, putrescent, hymenophore usually separating readily from the context. Hymenophore consisting of tubes, sometimes of shallow pits inside the hymenium. Gills are produced, sometimes their tubules are produced, sometimes these are reticulated tubes are there, and sometimes cysts are also there. In hymenophore consisting of lamellae, which are often united by conspicuous veins. Sometimes these gills are attached through the conspicuous veins, as in the case of Pegxiliaceae. In Bonitaceae, this consists of the tubes, which sometimes these are the shallow pits are also there. Basidiocarp is fleshy to tough or membranous, hymenophore not separating readily from context. Context of the sporophore containing nest of the sporocysts are there in case of Russulaceae. Spherocysts absent in case of Hygrophoraceae. Gills are not waxy, narrow in section in case of Agaricaceae family. In Bolitaceae, there are different characteristics which are present. The main characteristic feature is the presence of vertically arranged tubes on the underside of the pileus. Instead of gills, these are the tubes are present. How many of you have seen the different fruiting bodies in the forest? Anyone? No one has seen mushroom fruiting bodies? Now you tell me, how many of you are working in the field of mycology? Mycology means about the identification of the fungus. No one is working? You are working? You are also working. You are working on what? Okay, yourself? Fusarium. Nobody is working on macrofungi. Okay. This is the characteristics Russulaceae family, Hygrophoraceae family. These are the different characteristics, and it will be in your notes what are the different characteristics of the different families. Trichromatiaceae family. This is actually stipe is confluent with the pileus. Color of the spore is variable, yellow, pink, or brown. Armillaria you have seen. In the forest, if you go, sometimes you will be seeing a solid wood-like, long rope-like structure is growing from one plant to other plant. Actually, this is the armillaria, which is producing the fruiting bodies also, and from their mycelium, which is absorbing food. This is producing a rope-like structure, thin rope-like structure, which goes from one plant to another plant. That is called as the rhizoid, and this is the peculiarity of the Armillaria macrofungi. All right, Amanitaceae is important. Some people have classified this the type genus is Amanita, and they are characterized by producing these white colored spores. Amanita, Muscaria is about pink color fruit bodies it is producing. and this pink color fruiting is the type genus of the family Amanitaceae. Otherwise, so many species are there, and some are very lethal like Amanita verpa and Amanita phalloides. They produce amanitoxin also. Lamella are free from this type. The characteristic feature of this family is that vulva and annulus both are present. You know about vulva and annulus, what are these structures? This is the part of the universal beach which remains at the base is the vulva, and on the stipe upper side below the pileus, that is called as the annulus or ring. All right. So the characteristic feature of the Amanita genus is the presence of both the things, annulus as well as vulva. The spore color is white. Amanita virosa, Caesarea, Muscaria, phalloids. Amanita Caesarea and Amanita Muscaria. In fact, I told you about the King Claudius Caesar, which was murdered his wife, and you must be knowing about the Gautam Buddha. He was also supposed to be killed by the mushroom poisoning, and that was the Amanita phalloids or Amanita verpa, which was mixed in the for his dinner, along with the Amanita muscaria. And these Caesarea and Muscaria, these two species are edible, and in fact earlier these were used for their hallucinogenic properties. All right. For the identification of the toxins, whether these are produced or not, Wieland in 1978, he produced actually one test that is called as the Maxinger test to check whether the amatoxin is produced by the particular fungus or not. In that case, what he used to do is that he crushed the fruit body cap of the mushroom on any paper like newspaper or any paper which is containing lignin, and when that was dried, after drying of it, he put some HCl over it. That if it turns blue, then it means it is having amatoxin in it, and this amatoxin is very lethal. Agaricaceae, this is the Singer 1986. This is the largest family, about 25 genera. Best known example is Agaricus. How many have you eaten button mushroom? That all of you. So do you know the characteristic feature of the button mushroom? What type of spores it has? What is the color of those spores which is produced by the Agaricus? The Agaricus bisporus is the Agaricus brunescens species, which is also known as bisporus because it is having only two spores. Otherwise, four spores are there. And single spore isolation remains in case of Agaricus bisporus. Otherwise, in all the other species, these are tetrasporous. Only brunescens is the bisporus. That's why a common popular name is Agaricus bisporus of this common white button mushroom. The characteristic feature is the gray brown, white to gray brown cap. Pileus size, the main fruiting structure which you consume as a food. It is of white or gray color, easily separable from the pileus. With the slight touch, pileus will be come out. Otherwise, in most of the mushrooms, it is not, which are looks like in morphologically they will look like button mushroom, but their pileus does not come down, or it is separable from this type very easily. All right. These are characterized by the black or brown spores. In fact, the gills initially they are white or pinkish or cinnamon color, but later on becoming dark brown, chocolate brown or black in color. And the spores also, these are of dark brown color or the black color, the characteristic feature. Genus Labiota and Chlorophyllum are also placed by some in Labiotaceae family, but Singer put them in the family Agaricaceae. The Labiota genus is edible but superficially resembled with Amanita in possessing white spores. Okay? You know that the Amanita species, genus is producing white spores, that this so is the case of Labiota also, but Annulus and Volva, these are absent in case of Labiota. But Volva is lacking in Labiota and Annulus is conspicuous and persistent in case of Labiota. So Volva is the different structure which is Labiota is lacking. So the most advisable thing is this, that whenever you get mushrooms from the forest, don't consume it before the proper identification by the mushroom expert. The other is family, these are Strophoraceae and Coprinaceae also. In this Coprinaceae, these funguses are sometimes parasitic on the other mushrooms also. The characteristic feature of this basidiocarp is fragile. These grow on dung of the herbivorous plants. So for identification of the mushroom, it is also important that from where you have collected, what is the height of that place, in whether it was associated with some tree or not, it is mycorrhizal nature, it is saprophytic, what is the color. So all those different characteristics along with the color, size of the spores and their accumulations, all those things are very important for identification purpose. Plutaceae family, Cortinaceae family, all these things, if you are, because since you all are not working on it, so it will be difficult for you. You can take this slide from this computer if you all are interested for going all the details. The 15 families are there in Agaricales along with the Agaricaceae family. This is the Agaricaceae family. Some of the mushrooms I have shown you, Agaricus brunescens, this is the Agaricus bisporus, this is the gill structure, seeing the color, which is dark brown in color, and this is the ring structure present, this is the portions remaining from the partial wheel, which covers initially this hymenial structure in which gills are present, okay. But as soon as the mushroom matures, this structure layer is broken down and it remains here, okay. This is the case of Agaricus brunescens. Endophycum, these are the endophycum. Here these mushrooms are not easy from, in case of Agaricus, it is easily separable. But in this case, it is not easily separable. Here Labiota species is also there, it also looks like button mushroom, if superficially you will see, but there are different characteristics. Is the spores are white in case of Labiota, while in this the spores are brown or black in color. Labiota Clivopilaria, this is the species which is having some rough structures on this its pileus. Here Leucogarius species is there in which you are seeing this. All these gills, their attachment, their size, their shape, color, all these things are also important morphologically for the identification of the mushroom. In different slides, I will give you the different about the different terminologies and what are the different shapes and size and all those things of these things. In Amanitaceae family, you are saying the ring is annulus is there, volva is there. Amanita calyptera with conspicuous ring, it is there. Amanita muscaria, here the ring is here, volva is here. Amanita fulva, this is conspicuous, the conical shape and of the mushroom, and volva is there. Annulus is not so persistent in this case. Amanita virosa, here also you will be saying that the white like mushrooms are there, some yellowish spots will be there on the cap of the mushroom. Shape is like conical structure. So this is extremely poisonous, Amanita virosa, Amanita verpa, Amanita phalloides. दिस इज बॉलबिटेसी फैमिली, एगरोसाइबी मशरूम्स, दिस इज बॉलबिटस, दिस इज गैस्ट्रोसाइबी मशरूम्स. सो ऑल आर डिफरेंट शेप्स साइज. कॉप्रिनेसी फैमिली, कॉप्रिनस कोमेटस इज हियर, दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द इंक टाइप फंगस. हियर द पीलियस इज फ्रिजाइल एंड दिस प्रोड्यूस इंकी, दिस आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज इंकी कैप बिकॉज दिस पीलियस डिजेनरेट. एंड शेगी माने इज द अदर नेम विच इज इन अर्लियर स्टेज वेन दिस इज यंग, इट इज इन दिस शेप वेन इट इज यंग इट इज एडाइबल. Coprinus comatus, this is the fragile structure. The outer surface of this pileus, it is like this. So the, all these characters are used for identification of the mushrooms. This is Coprinus altermetarius, podaxis also, this is also edible mushrooms. Here this is the longitudinal section of this mushroom. You are seeing this is the dark gill portion is there. Quaternarius, here you are seeing that decurrent type of gills, you will be seeing it, but these are not actually gills, this is the some thinny hair like structures which is covering the gill over here, and these are extending to the stipe. It looks like that the gills are decurrent here. The family Agaricaceae of the agaricales, different structures are there. Some of the agaricus mushrooms, Agaricus campestris, Lepiota, Morganae, Armillaria, Melia, known as honey agaric also, these are forming the rhizomorph. And sometimes in the green field, lawn, you must have seen the in the fairy ring structures of the different types of mushrooms, they are growing there. Okay. So this is the fairy ring structure. Successive crops of this basidiocarp, this is the fruiting structure of the mushroom. Produced successively season by season in a ring type structure which is called as the fairy ring. There are three main types of fairy rings. I am not going into details. Lepiota, Morganae, Tricholoma persoonatum and Agaricus. Prairimosas. These are the different fairy ring mushrooms. Some of the edible agarics are Agaricus campestris, Agaricus bisporus, Coprinus, Lepiota, Merasmius, Trichroma. Merasmius aureates also form a fairy ring structure in the lawns. Poisonous ones are Amanita muscaria, Amanita phalloides, Amanita verna. This is the general structure. Growth of the pileus initially. This is the vulva, okay, the wheel is there. As soon as the matures, the universal wheel starts rupturing. Here you are seeing the different growth. This is the vulva, this is the stipes and annulus, these are the gills, and this is the pileus, and remnants of the vulva on the cap of the size. These are the different types of attachment of the stipe to their pileus. Here in found in Agaricaceae family. In case of Amanita, this is sometimes it is conical shape and some remnants of the wheels are also there. Annulus vulva presence is there. In case of this is Agaricus species in which vulva is not there, ring like structure, annulus sometimes present here. In Volvaria is the fungus Volvaria, okay. This is also a macro fungi in which this is the structure. Here the base is somewhat different, pileus is somewhat thinner, okay. And Clytocybe, Colibia, and here Clytocybe, this type of structure is there. Sometimes here you will be seeing that this is in case of the Clytocybe, it is a funnel like structure it produces, and the stipe is attached at the center. And in Pleurotus species, the spite this all structure, the stipe is attached at the margin. The rest of the fruiting bodies and this in this case schizophyllum, it is there. Okay, this is the case of Liriotus. Here this is Clytocybe. This is case of Liriotus. In general structure, the gills, trauma, the inside of the structure which is not producing spores is called as the trauma. This is called as the some hymenial structure. The spore producing part, basidiocarp, which is having this is basidium, in which basidiospores are produced. This is called as the hymenium, which is covered by the gill here inside it. This is the paraphysis, okay, in which basidiospores are produced. This is the basidium. These are the gill structures, basidium, stalagmata, basidiospores. Now about going through the details, if you say they're centrally stipitate, what is it is? When the pileus, the stipe is usually attached to surface of the pileus at its center, then it is centrally stipitate. Eccentrically stipitate or marginally stipitate, when it is attached to the margin, in case of Liriotus, it is marginally, and when laterally, it is eccentric, not at the center and not at the margin. That is eccentric. Okay? You got it or not? When stipe is attached to the pileus at the center, it is called as the centrally stipitate. When it is attached at the margin, it is called as marginally stipitate. And when not at the center and not when at the margin, it is called as the centrally stipitate. This is eccentrically stipitate. All right. The pileus may be laterally. It is called as the different terminology you have to use while describing a fungus. In case you are working on the macro fungi, then you have to describe it. If sometimes it is the pileus is coriaceous, then what will you understand? It means it is leathery, hairy structure, tomentose, with or without scales. Okay, you must have some scales like structures are there on the cap or the main portion of the pileus. Campanulate. When dry, the pileus may change its color. The pileus may be bell-shaped, campanulate. Cone-shaped, it is conic. Inverted cone-shaped is obconic. S-shaped, revoluted, involute. Infundibulum, when it is funnel-shaped, okay? With a pit or a small depression at the center, it is umbilicate. With a knob producing from the center, ammonate. With radiating marks or furrows near the edge, stipulate or striate. And split at the edge where squamosa or squamulose. At the end, when this splits, like in earlier slide, I have shown you one picture in which the end of the pileus was like a broom. Okay? Or the attachment of the gills. Gills may be a broad or narrow, varying with different species in distinction made between the gills that extend to the stem known as adnexed. Those that are attached broadly to the stem, it is adnate, and others that do not reach it but ends before the attaching to the stipe or the main stem of the fruit body, that is called as the adnate. Gills that run down to the stem, when gills are coming and they are coming to the stipe also or the stem of the fruit body also, that condition is called as the decurrent. That those are notched in there as near the stem are known as the sinuate or emarginate. Sometimes I will show you in other portion of the lecture about this different shapes also of these things, in which it is forming a notch like structure which is attached to the stem, these gills. Okay, this is about the coprinus. I told you This is about the spore print which you have to take. Okay. This is the key for the identification. How to avoid mushroom poisoning? The better thing is this, that whatever the mushrooms you take from the forest, don't eat them until and unless properly identified. This is the Amanita caesarea. This is the Amanita phalloides. Okay, different mushrooms of the Amanita. These are the suggested readings here. And coming to the next lecture, ma'am, there is one more portion of the lecture remaining, which give some characteristic idea. नील पेन ड्राइव तो निकाल ली, ये कॉपी किया हुआ है ये वाला. Now we are coming to the go through, because the time is less now left. Agaricus gill mushroom taxonomy. All right, these are the five different characters which are taken into account: microscopic characters, shape of the cap, attachment of the gills to the stalk, shape of the stalk, position of the stalk, and use the proper mushroom guide for identification purpose. Shape of the cap is cylindrical, conical, bell-shaped, ambonate-shaped, convex-shaped, plane, uplifted, umbilicate, depressed, or funnel-shaped. All you have to describe it. And when the in literature it is written umbilicate full body. So you must understand what is the umbilicate, how it looks like. All right. The attachment of gills. These are free, not attaching with the stipe. This is the pilea. This is the stipe. So these are the gill portion which is not attaching. Adnexed, narrowly attached with the stipe. Sinuate, forming a notch. Adnate, when broadly attached to the stipe. Decurrent, when these gills continue to grow on the stipe. Shape of the stalk is there, tapering downwards, equal, tapering upward, emerge below, bulbous, base. Position of the stalk, it is central, off central, eccentric, lateral, not actually, this is the stipe and different fruit bodies coming from it. This is called as the lateral. Abent, sessile, without any stalk. Three major characteristics of the families of the gill mushrooms are the spore color, gill attachment, and wheel. Spore color, light spore print, white, yellow, pink, dark spore print, black, purple, brown, red, rust green. Okay, so there are the different characteristics when taken and the spores. But in some cases, I told you that the spores are not forcibly discharged. Then what will it do? When this fruit body degenerates itself, like in tubers and all those things, then only you can take out the print, or by breaking the fruit body. The spores are forcibly not discharged, so you cannot take a spore print. So in different mushrooms, you have to adopt a different technique. Assuming spore color without a spore print, okay, this is the fruit body, gill color is there, you have to take into account. But in maturity, after gaining maturity, the spore color also become different. Like in case of common mushroom, that is called as the Agaricus bisporus button mushroom, initially it will look like a pinkish in color, but later on in maturity becomes dark brown or black in color. Gill attachment, when it is free, actually not attached to the stipe here. Amanita pluteus, gill attachment decurrent, I told you it is growing to the stipe or stem in case of Clytocyvi. Gill attachment adnate to adnex here, you are seeing the attachment in case of Russula. Okay. Wheel tissues, universal, partial, or none. Partial wheel and universal wheel, these are present in Amanita. This is in universal wheel, remnants are there, and annulus is there, and vulva is there. Amanita muscaria, you won't find it. This is the longitudinal section of the Amanita. Partial wheel in case of Agaricus. Here it is there. Remnants remains as in the form of the ring in case of Agaricus species. Gills are not attached to the stipe. So some characteristics are there from which initial identification you can do. Universal wheel remnants are there sometimes in case as in case of scaly like structure, collar like structures is there, sac like structure is there, indistinct like structures are there. Partial wheel remnants also in the form of the rings are there. Okay. Wheel remnants on margin of the caps are also there. These are the margins. In Stropharia mushrooms, you will see such types of wheels like structure. So initial identification you can do, you can guess it that this may be the, this mushroom, and with the proper mushroom guide, after studying different characteristics, then you can identify it. Agaricales, light spore. These are the light spore families. These produce dark spores. Amanitaceae, spore print is white. Amyloid spores, gills free. Amanita species, universal plus partial wheel are there. Universal wheel is there only here in this case of Amanita species. Labiotaceae family, spore is white, I told you, but the partial wheel is there, gills are free here. Dextrinoid spores are there in case, this is, spores are white and dextrinoid. These are the dextrinoid spores, a notch-like structure is present in case of spores. Trichlomataceae family, spores are white, yellow, pinkish, amyloid spores attached, partial wheels. Okay, this is Tricholoma, spore print white, medium to large fruiting body, solitary or in groups, notch gill attachment, may or may not be present, wheels may or may not be present, cap board, broad, often with a streak coloration of the pileus. Alright, Tricholomataceae, marasmias, broad gills are there, widely spaced gills are there, and these are gills are wavy also, not straight. This type often weary, lapid-like structures, not very thick. Trichlomataceae mycenia, spores are white, small fruiting body, gregarious, no wheel, cap bell-shaped, margin rarely incurved. This is mycenia. Armillaria, this I was talking about, which were forming rhizoids, a rope-like structure extending very long, sometimes in meters, and these are spores are white, cap dark, scales or hairs, tough fibrous stalk, stalk base yellow, corny wheel. Lacaria species, tough fibrous stalk, thick, widely spaced gills, cap centrally depressed, spores are spiny. Trichlomataceae family, Clytocybe is there, spores are white to yellowish or pinkish, decurrent gills, decurrent nature, extend to the stipe. No wheel, cap often funnel shaped at maturity. All right. Aromatic, some fumes, fragrance is also there. Cystoderma, granulose cap, distinct partial wheel, umbo, white spore. Hygrophoraceae family, spores are white, medium to large fruiting bodies, white to pallid, dry to viscid, waxy caps, gills adnate to decurrent. Hygrocybe, here small fruiting bodies, brightly colored, dry to viscid, waxy caps, gills free, adnex, rarely decurrent, stalk similar to cap. Pleurotaceae family, spores are white, stipe is lateral or absent, gills are attached, partial wheel is sometimes present. Pleurotus on hardwoods, on the wood logs of the dried plants, it also grows, or artificially cultivated commercially also. Spores are round and white. Pleurotaceae, Pleurocybella, these grows on coniferous trees, shelf fungi, thinner pillar fruiting bodies, spores round and white. Agaricaceae, spores is chocolate brown, gills are free, partial wheel. This is the characteristic feature of the common button mushroom. Agaricus, I have shown you this thing, that later on, it, initially it is white, then pinkish, then it becomes chocolate brown. Here the other characteristic is that PDS is easily detachable from the stalk. Cortinaceae family, spores are brown to orange, gills attached, partial wheel may or may not be present, universal wheel may or may not be present in different species. Cortinarius, this is the partial wheel, cob webby fibers are present over cortina, universal wheel but not volva. Okay, volva is not present in this case here. Inosaibi, cap ambonate, dry and silky, no distinct annulus is present, smell like green corn. Habiloma, cap is viscid, wheel absent, smell like radish like. Strophoraceae, spores are purplish brown, black or brown, gill attached, partial wheel present. Strophoria, cap bright color, viscid, annulus or fringe, typically not cespitos. Different species are there in margin, you must be seeing fringe like structures are there. Hypholoma, formerly nematoloma, cap is bright color, not viscid, not distinct annulus, cespitos on wood. Grows on woods, this is the wood structure of the dried plants. Coprinaceae, spores black, gill free or attached, partial wheel is present. Coprinus, Coprinus comatus or shegimane, I told you. These are also called as inky mushrooms, and in initial stage when young, these are edible. Translucent striate cap, autodigestive gills are there. On maturity, gills digest themselves and forms a liquid black ink-like structure, so also called as inky mushrooms. Entolomataceae family, spore pink, gill attached, wheel absent. This is Entoloma. Stalk often twisted and fibrous, twisted stalk. Angular spores, spores are angular here. Pluteaceae family, spore pink, gill free, universal wheel present. Pluteus, these grow on woods, no wheels, cystidia are also present on the gills. Other gill fungi are Ruzulaceae, Bolitales, Chanterelles. Ruzulaceae, the Ruzulaceae orders, spore white, amyloid spores attached. Amyloid spores characteristic feature is this, that I told you one test earlier, that how to test this amyloid, nature of the plants or spores. Spores are white, yellowish, amyloid spores, gill attached, wheel absent. Ruzula, the color is pinkish reddish mixed white. Fruiting body brittle, stalk snaps often cleanly like a piece of chalk. This, if you break, it breaks like a chalk. Strongly amyloid. Ruzulaceae family, lactarius is there like a piece of chalk. This breaks like a piece of straw. Strongly amyloid spores with ornamentation, latex color change. Bolitales, Bolitaceae, Suilaceae, Gomphidaceae, Paxilaceae. There are different species in coming in Bolitales order. Bolitus, reticulate stalk is there. You are seeing is Bolitus, reticulated stalk. Base of the stalk conspicuous and bulbous. Using the action is there with the iodine. If you see test the tissue or the emerging sap from the tissue of this, it will give you a blue reaction with the iodine. Suilus is in the Suilaceae family. This is here partial wheel is also present here. Slimy cap is slimy here. Radially arranged pores are there instead of straight gills. Stalk with glandular dots. Okay, so all these structures, morphological features, these are used for the identification of the mushrooms. Gomphidaceae. Spores are smoky gray, gills are decurrent, partial wheel is there. Gomphidius is the genus, which is type genus. Cap slimy, wheel slimy, gills whitish when young, becoming smoke gray, base of the stalk bright yellow. Gomphidaceae family, Crugomo first is the other species, ear cap not slimy, wheel not slimy, inconspicuous annulus sometimes may be present, gills orangish when young. Initially when gill you see it is orangish in color. Pagellacy, spores are white, yellowish to brown, gill decurrent and forked or veined, wheel absent. Pagellus is the species here, enrolled margin is there, margin is enrolled. Okay, you see it? Hairy or velvet stalk, stalk is here hairy and velvet between gills. Okay, pagellacy, hygropropsis, false chanterelles, it is on wood, grows on wood, spores are white and cystoid. Cantharellaceae family, spores are white, decurrent gills are there, gills broad, fork shaped, forked or shallow. This is Cantharellus, chanterelle, stalk solid and firm, solid stalk and firm, hard stalk. Craterellus, black trumpet like structure it is forming, stalk hollow with hymenium, smooth to wrinkled. This is about in general the introduction of the morphological features of the mushrooms or the macro fungi. And now I invite the questions if you want to ask anything. Yes, please.
Sir, generally in case of poisonous mushrooms, vulva, universal veil or rings are present. In case of edible mushroom, it is not present or maybe we cannot see through naked eye.
There is no reason for that, whether why it is not present in case of the edible mushrooms. The spore print in the poisonous mushroom is generally spore color is white, okay, and so different characteristics, attachment to the gills, of the gills to this type, what nature is there, what is the color of the gills, all those things are important criteria. But poisonous nature is because of the some types of the toxins which are produced, okay. So actually nobody knows about it that why these are produced in, because these are produced in some macro fungi, so that's why it is called as the known as the poisonous. When the spores are forcibly discharged in the fruiting bodies, in some class of the mushrooms, as I told you earlier, hymenomycetes and this gasteromycete. In case of gasteromycete fungus, like ball type structures and all those things, these are not forcibly discharged. Once you have to break the fruit bodies, then the spores can be taken out. But in case of these hymenomycetes fungus, what happens that you have to clean the fruit body of the fungus and invert it in a sterile atmosphere. I mean, you have to take a paper, butter paper, you have to take it, okay, sterilize it, surface sterilize it, then under the one beaker, big beaker, you have to sterilize it after autoclaving it, then you have to put it over it. Inside it, you have to hang upside downward, fruit body gill portion must remain below side. After cutting the stipe from the base, you keep it. After 3-4 days, what happens that the spores when mature, they will be forcibly discharged. Okay, this you have to do after all surface sterilizing all of the body of the mushrooms. Then you have to take the print out. So spore print from there, you can see the color of the spores. Then after taking this single spores or different multiple spores, you can microscopically and see under microscope what type of accumulation it is having, what type of other structures are there.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Okay.
Any other question? So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for listening patiently for this lecture.